podcast, Cole's Notes version of what we did today. Today on the podcast, we smoked the Cabaguan El Wapo, paired with the Knob Creek 100 Proof small batch whiskey. Fantastic pairing today. Absolutely love it. Nothing we smoke pairs poorly with this Knob Creek 100 Proof, and we have yet to smoke a bad Tatuaje cigar.
So far, so good. Yeah, I agree. Thanks for watching. Oh, we're gonna really do it too. Okay.
So this cigar was a Nicaraguan binder and fillers wrapped with some Ecuadorian Habano? No.
Ecuadorian...
Sumatra? No.
Ecuadorian...
Sungrown.
Sungrown. Ecuadorian sungrown. Yeah, yeah.
There you go.
We figured it out.
One minute on the clock. So that's going to be 1 minute each, 2 minute warning cigar review. Are you ready, James?
I think so, yeah.
Go ahead.
So the Tatuaje Cabaguan is just a rich, smooth, beautiful cigar. When it started out, there were like some hay notes and some spicy kind of exotic flavors that I couldn't put my finger on. But I think that comes down to the binder fillers, the Nicaraguan experience. I think that's what was coming through in that, and I've always enjoyed that. Off the top, it smelled fairly fermented. It had that barnyardy flavor, smell, aroma that we all end up knowing that I like when it comes through in a cigar. Definitely didn't fail me. At the halfway point, the flavor profile kind of switched a bit. A lot of those sharper notes and those hay notes were getting blended in with like a really rich cocoa note. All in all, the cigar had a sweet flavor throughout, which left it feeling very desserty. Now, the Knob Creek, being a very caramelized and charred wood oak flavors, I think they just blended really well. And it left like a desserty feeling on my palate. Like, this is a great unwind pairing to finish off a shitty week if you had one.
Well, you shouldn't have had a shitty week. It's been Christmas week, New Year.
Yeah, so shitty like everyone else's.
What can I say? There's nothing bad for me to ever say about a Tatuaje cigar. These cigars smoke phenomenal. Never had one with a tight draw. Never had one with burn issues. Rarely ever have to relight. The Tatuaje Cabaguan El Wapo is a tasty, complex cigar with some nice pepper and spice that paired excellently with the Knob Creek 100 Proof. Really has some vanilla notes in there that really paired well and jived well with the Tatuaje Cabaguan. Not a lot of fire ethanol taste, considering it's 100 proof whiskey. This Kentucky bourbon by Knob Creek goes down so smooth. Don't be afraid of the 100 proof. It's a fantastic bottle of whiskey. Go out and get yourself a bottle of Knob Creek 100 proof. Get yourself some Cabaguan El Wapos. It's the darker wrapper of the Cabaguans. They're normally a shade grown. This one's a Ecuadorian sun grown, nice dark wrapper with some tooth in it. Fantastic pairing today. Smoke good cigars, drink good booze, eat good food. Cheers.
Cheers.
Look, Twitter, Instagram. Listen and subscribe to the Cigar Dungeon Podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, TuneIn, Stitcher, Spotify, Libsyn.com. Join the War Pig Social Club. When you join, you get a free patch. Links are in all our social media profiles. Look for at War Pigs SC on all our social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. The Cigar Dungeon Podcast today was brought to you by the letter R, as in Rush, the greatest Canadian rock band ever. And the number 6, as in 6 inches is a perfectly average size for a penis. And Budweiser, the king of beers, for people tired of drinking expensive hipster piss. And Cabo Wabo Tequila, making babies for over 20 years. In fact, if you're having trouble getting your lady pregnant, it's because she's not drunk enough. And Big Dick's Halfway In Resort, rooms by the hour, massages, turn down service available. Ask for Big Dick. And Pornhub. Pay for your porn. But if you're gonna be a cheap cunt, go fuck yourself and watch Pornhub.com.